You filming?
Yeah.
Huh? Hello, I'm Jeff Kramer. Welcome to Colombian Moto Adventures. We're out here in the beautiful backcountry outside of Medellin. It's a super beautiful day. We're riding motorcycles around. I invite y'all to come on down, ride motorcycles with me. It's a good time. And as they say, the only risk is wanting to stay. Hello, I'm Jeff Kramer. I'm the owner of Colombian Moto Adventures. We are out here in the beautiful hills outside of Medellin. I thought I'd show you the Honda XRE 300 that we have available for rent out here. It is the perfect bike for riding around Colombia. Check it out. This is a dual sport bike. It's good for highway, it's good for off-road. It's lightweight. It only weighs 144 kilograms with a 300cc motor. A lot of people say, they're like, oh, I'm used to riding like a 1200cc BMW or an F800 or a larger bike. But out here, look at the terrain back here. Hills and twists and turns and all sorts of stuff. You can be on off-road, on-road, steep stuff, all sorts of terrain. You're rarely gonna break 60 miles an hour out here. I mean, I almost never break 60 miles an hour. You never break 100 kilometers an hour out here. The bikes are lightweight. They're really, really easy to maneuver. If you get into off-road situations, it's totally fine. You can handle the situations on this. This is used by the Colombian National Police. It's used by the Brazilian military. It'll get you in and out of any situation you could possibly imagine, and they're super reliable. Check this out. I'll show you some of the other features we have on the bikes. Here is a 48. This is a 48 liter top box. We could open it up and you can see that it holds a backpack really easily. So that's good. There's room for all your stuff. If you go on like a week long trip, throw your stuff in there, you're cool. Another thing we got on all of our bikes, these are Metzler Sahara off-road tires. You can see they got a lot of tread on them. And so you're not gonna be slipping and sliding all around. And if you want, you can choose to have your choice of off-road tires, or we can switch to on-road tires, but I usually just keep the off-road ones on here. Another thing we have here is a ram mount cell phone holder. So this sits right on the handlebars. Just go like this, throw your cell phone in there, it locks into place. You can put these little rubber deals around it for even more security. And then the charger cable goes into a USB charging port that we have installed on the bike. So you can just plug in your destination with Google Maps or whoever you choose to use. Your phone will be charged the whole way and you can just go. A lot of people, they contact me and say, hey, Jeff, is this a trip that I can do on my own? I don't know the roads, I don't speak that much Spanish. And it is something that you can do. You can do it easily without a guide, right? All I just recommend people do, plug in your phone, plug in Google Maps, and you just go. The riding's easy, the people are really friendly. It's just a good time, and it's easy to do, and everyone's so cool with you out here. You don't need to know that much Spanish, just a little basic Spanish, or use Google Translate and you've got it. I think that pretty much covers it. If there's anything else you want to know, give me a call, I'll help you out. See y'all later. Come out riding Colombia. The only risk is wanting to stay. Show you around. It's just playing our little arcade game that we have here, playing some Street Fighter. But check it out. This is where we fix all the bikes and do all our stuff. And we have a special guy. This is Chester the dog. He's always with me here at the shop. And then this is Brian.
Hello.
He's got a big Doberman with us. And these are just different people and different characters that you meet here at the shop and up here in San Cristobal, Colombia. Here's one of the bikes that we're fixing up, a Kawasaki Versus. Every time we fix a bike, we go through like a checklist of 20 different things that we check out to make sure that when you get that bike, it's always working, always running properly. You're not gonna have any troubles when you're out driving around. Over here, here's the counter. This is probably what, besides a video game, This is probably one of the most important things we have. We've got the coffee machine, drinking coffee every morning. We've got the oil spare parts back here. This is where we get all the parts for the motorcycles. Coming back here, come on. This here used to be an old house. So what we have here, this area, is the shower where we wash the motorcycles, the pressure washer. And for the privacy of the motorcycles, we have a shower curtain here. And there's a pressure washer. Then coming back through here, this is the workbench. We've got all the tools here. Here's a bike that we're fixing up. I guess they're working on the electrical system on this one. Over here to the right, we've got some bikes going on. These are waiting for parts. Some we're fixing up a little bit. Back there on the wall, this is a list of all the bikes and their mileage for oil changes and stuff. This is Elke. Hello. Hola. Thank you. Elke's already clean. This is another Versus. We're waiting on a part for this one. And we've got welders back here. We've got stick welders. We've got MIG welders. Everything for welding. Scrap metal that we're going to be taking out of here today. Got some oil. There's the MIG welder that we got. We use that all the time. Here are the sticks for the stick welder. Right there. And this is the shop. So what I thought I would do is I will, now that you've seen the shop, I thought I'd show you kind of the route that we're taking around Colombia. So check it out. Hello, I'm here with Yorli, the owner of the shop.
Hello, Yorli, ¿cómo están?
We're here in just the office, and we're gonna jump on the computer. I'll show you the route that we're gonna take around through Colombia. It is very, very cool. So we'll zoom in here and I'll show you what's going on. So here we go. What we're gonna do is on day one, we leave from Medellin, from my office up in San Cristobal. We'll get all the helmets, we'll get all the bikes, we'll pack everything up. Then we'll head out, we'll cross Medellin, we'll stop at a couple of overlooks to see the city, and we're gonna head to a place called Guatape. Guatape is a really beautiful place. Probably one of the most visited places in all of Antioquia. And what it is, it's a big, huge, gigantic rock that you can climb up and you get a view of all of Antioquia. And it's also located on a lake with all these islands on the inside of it. And it's really, really beautiful. We'll spend the night in Guatape, and the next day we're gonna drive down to a place called Sonson. That's just a really small town on the Colombian countryside. And the road to get there is just this windy, curvy, awesome road with spectacular views. And there's very little traffic on that road, so that's really cool. In Sonson, we can get a pizza. We're gonna stay at an awesome hotel that's filled with these antiques. It's a really cool place. And then we can check out a place called the Paramo, which is Colombian tundra, except it's without the permafrost. It's cool, there's a beautiful view out there. From Sonson, we're gonna go down to a place called Salamina. That's an off-road drive. It's also crazy beautiful through the coffee region there. There's gonna be coffee plants on all sides of us when we're driving through there. In Salamina, it's also a beautiful town located on the side of a mountain. And it's a national heritage site. And right near there, we're gonna drive out and we're gonna visit some wax palms. And that's the National Tree of Colombia. They're about 150, 200 feet tall. It's really, really beautiful. It's so crazy beautiful. After that, we're gonna drive down. We're gonna go to Manizales. We're gonna stay at a hot springs hotel located on the side of a volcano. That's also crazy beautiful. I keep saying that, but it's true. The next day from the hot springs, we're gonna go down to Salento. We're gonna check out Salento. We can visit a coffee farm down there. After Salento, we're going to go down to the Valle de Cauca. We're gonna go to Cali, Colombia. That's the salsa capital of Colombia, and it's like a pretty big party town. I used to live there, and I really like it a lot. We're gonna spend a night or two in Cali. Then we're gonna go out to a place called Buenaventura. And on the way, we're gonna stop at a place called San Cipriano. We're gonna drive some motorcycles down some railroad tracks. It's hard to explain. Basically what they do, there's no access to the town in San Cipriano, so they modify these motorcycles and they stick them on the railroad tracks, and people sit on these carts and they go down to the town. It's cool. We're gonna be in Buena Ventura, then we're gonna start heading back. We're gonna go up to Pereira, spend the night there, then we're gonna go up to Jardín. And in Jardín, they call it the most beautiful small town in Colombia. We're gonna spend the night there. And then from Jardín, we're just gonna drive back in, and we're gonna kind of take the long way around. And we're gonna go through some very beautiful, beautiful countryside up in the mountains. The other way is going through the valley, but that's not cool. But we're gonna go winding through the mountains again on our way back to Medellin. And then that should be the trip. So I'm looking forward to seeing all you guys, and talk to you later. Bye now. Hey dudes, there's one more thing I want to tell you. I've been sitting here editing this video, and I forgot to mention that we have a support vehicle, a really cool off-road adventure van. Check it out. See y'all later.
Everybody sing along. Everything has been said before. Nothing left to say anymore. But it's all the same. You can ask for it by name.
Everybody, I hope to see y'all down here soon. And I hope you like the video. If you have any questions, give me a call. See y'all later.
Bye.
Ciao. Bye bye.